Hey, I'm Chris Paris, Chief Investment Officer at Oak Harvest Financial Group. Our investment team is pleased to introduce a new midweek release in which we will examine a news item, headline, or story making the rounds from publicly available sources and ask the question, is it news or is it noise? Our constant advice for investors is to tune out the noise. But sometimes it's hard to know what's noise and what's not. That's what this series is going to be about. These are going to be quick, casual opinion pieces, and while we will use data to derive our conclusions, we'll be wrong in our interpretations at least some of the time. However, we are looking to practice what we preach and help investors to rationally and critically analyze emotion-laden stories. Before we continue, please take a moment to hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so that you'll be notified when we upload new content. So here we go. I just want to say one word to you. Just one word. Metaverse. Isn't that a line from a recent Mark Zuckerberg movie called The Dropout? Or am I getting that confused with the term plastics in the 1967 film The Graduate? Doesn't matter. This is news. And I recommend everyone, particularly anyone over the age of 50, go watch Mark Zuckerberg's video that was released on October 28th. You don't have to like him one bit, but it's still worth watching. Viewers, I must mention that the investment team at Oak Harvest first discussed the metaverse in detail on March 26th of this year. That's 8 months ago, before the recent swirl and hype, in the podcast we titled Digital Widgets, Bitcoin, NFTs, and the Metaverse. We did this when others in the market were talking about peak economic growth and were concerned about slowdowns. At that time, any stock that could be considered a Metaverse investment play was out of favor. Back then, semiconductor stocks in the group, unloved. Software names in the group, overpriced was the talk on TV. So what is the Metaverse? Well, it's a collectively shared digital space that integrates both our own physical outside world with a digital virtual community. Communities like gaming, where there are over 600 million Minecraft citizens. Microsoft owns Minecraft. The game Fortnite, owned by Epic Games, has over 350 million players. Or World of Warcraft, with over 100 million players, owned by Activision. Roblox is for younger gamers. It already has 150 million monthly users. These are user bases bigger than many countries. Like it or not, this is the likely direction of entertainment, education, and communication down the line. The semiconductor and its ability to store, retrieve, and transfer data at hyperspeeds is making the possibilities for new digital applications almost endless. Entertainment, it's already here. Education distribution, the changes are coming. Healthcare, we're in the early innings. These semiconductors are being designed around technology provided by both NVIDIA and AMD and a few others. They are being manufactured by the likes of Taiwan Semiconductor using capital equipment from ASM Lithography, Applied Materials, and KLA Corp. If you want a glimpse at the future, just go watch a few of the following movies. Ready Player One, directed by Steven Spielberg, or Avatar, directed by James Cameron, or the Matrix series with Keanu Reeves in it. Already in gaming communities in the metaverse, you can buy goods and services in digital form and transact with others in your community. I know it may sound wasteful to some. I mean, why would anyone buy a digital sword or special armor to play a video game? However, many people see paying $4 or $5 for a coffee at Starbucks as wasteful as well. To me, they are both forms of satisfying one's desire for entertainment. No one knows who will the eventual winners and losers be over the next decade or two in the race to monetize the metaverse. Just as we didn't know 20 years ago that Amazon and Google would claim supremacy over the first wave of internet growth. However, we do know this. This is where both millennials and Gen Z age consumers are spending much of their current spare time, their energy, and their money. So this is where the future, our economy, and the money will be going. Many of us, particularly older generations, may not like this kind of progress or news story. But like it or not, our world is becoming more digital every day, and the metaverse is heading to a computer, phone, or new distribution device near you. As Thanos said when he snapped his fingers at the end of the Avengers Endgame movie, I'm inevitable. So too is the metaverse in whatever form it takes in our future. Viewers, like it or not, this is news. Give us a call here at Oak Harvest and ask to speak to one of our advisors. Let us help you craft a financial plan that meets your retirement goals and needs first and your greed second. Give us a call here at 877-896-0040. We're here to help you on your financial journey into and through your retirement years. I'm Chris Paris, and have a great week.